Oh, it's finished. Well, welcome, though it's a bit strange me being a visitor, but welcome to our service today. Now, I came a few weeks ago, or was it a few months ago? I can't remember. And what really stood out to me was the wonderful music. Your singing was wonderful, but what really impressed me was your fellowship together. That was obvious that you've opened your hearts to each other, that you care for each other, that you want to be alongside each other. And the gospel today is about Thomas. He wasn't there for the first experience of the resurrection, and his heart was closed. He wanted proof that the resurrection would actually had happened. But of course, when he meets Jesus, he opens his heart. And that's what fellowship is all about, opening our hearts and not having closed hearts to each other. Sorry, a long welcome. Alleluia, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Praise the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ.
He has given us new life and hope by raising Jesus from the dead.
And Mark is going to come and light our Paschal candle today. We always look for tall people.
Last time I was, I can't be church a lot.
Oh dear.
No, I think.
You got it. No, you just put it out.
So let's now spend a few moments in silence. Have we sung our first hymn yet?
No, we're going to do our opening hymn in a minute, after a moment of silence.
Sorry. And prepare our hearts to worship God. And as we begin that, let's have our first hymn, which is hymn number 75.
Thank you.
few moments in silence, thinking about the times we have loved God with all our hearts, mind and spirit, and our neighbours ourselves. Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart. Like Mary at the empty tomb, we fail to grasp the wonder of your presence. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Like the disciples behind locked doors, we are afraid to be seen as your followers. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Like Thomas in the upper room, we are slow to believe. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Father forgive us by the death of his Son and strengthen us to live in the power of the Spirit all our days.
Amen.
And now we stand and sing the Gloria together. Let us pray. Risen Christ, for whom no door is locked, no entrance barred, open the doors of our hearts, that we may seek the good of others and walk the joyful road of sacrifice and peace, to the praise of God the Father.
Amen.
Would you like to sit for our readings?
The first reading is taken from the book of Acts, chapter 4, verses 32 to 35, and can be found on page 1035 in the Church Bibles. All the believers were one in heart and mind. No one claimed that any of their possessions was their own, but they shared everything they had. With great power, the apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And God's grace was so powerfully at work in them all that there were no needy persons among them. From time to time, those who owned land or houses sold them, brought the money from the sales, and put it at the apostles' feet. And it was distributed to anyone who had need. The second reading is taken from 1 John 1, and it's chapters 1 and chapter 2, verses 1 and 2, and it can be found on page 1158 in the Church Bibles. That which was from the beginning, which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes, which we have looked at and our hands have touched, this we proclaim concerning the word of life. The life appeared, we have seen it and testified to it, and we proclaim to you the eternal life which was with the Father and has appeared to us. We proclaim to you that we have seen and heard, so that you may also have fellowship with us. And our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. We write this to make our joy complete. This is the message we have heard from him and declare to you. God is light. In him there is no darkness at all. If we claim to have fellowship with him and yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live out the truth. But if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, purifies us all from sin. If we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just, and will forgive us our sins, and purify us from all unrighteousness. If we claim we have not sinned, we make him out to be a liar, and his word is not in us. My dear children, I write this to you so that you will not sin. But if anybody does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is the atoning sacrifice for our sins, and not only for ours, but also for the sins of the whole world. This is the word of God, the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So I think we now stand and sing our gradual hymn, hymn number 401, Jesus Stand Among Us.
Christ is risen from the dead.
Alleluia.
He has defeated the powers of death.
Alleluia.
Jesus turns our sorrows into dancing.
Alleluia.
He has the words of eternal life.
Alleluia.
Hear the words of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you." As the Father has sent me, so I send you. When he had said this, he breathed on them and said, Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, We have seen the Lord. But he said to them, Unless I see the marks of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe. A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, Peace be with you. Then he said to Thomas, Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe. Thomas answered him, My Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe. In today's gospel reading, the disciples are locked behind closed doors. And we all know about closed doors in our own lives, don't we? The locked doors of our fears and doubts, the locked doors of our anger and maybe resentment, our inner wounds that we carry with us throughout our lives, and the secrets of our hearts that only God knows. The Bible reveals something, that there's something incomplete with us, something that needs to be changed, something in us that needs divine mending, something in us that needs divine love, something in us that needs divine peace. Hence, Good Friday. The marks on his body reveal his deep and wide love for each one of us. Not just us, but all people, past, present, and in the future. He reached out his arms on the cross to bring reconciliation and peace into every person. St. Augustine of Hippo wrote that the human heart is restless until it rests in God. But as human beings, we are prone to fix in our own way this emptiness that we experience sometimes, maybe when our prayers are not answered. But we know that we often fail because we try to fix ourselves without the one who can. Our gospel tells us that Jesus came and stood among them and said, Peace be with you. I love the gospel of John because of the vision he has for Christ. He says, God loved the world so much that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. That's the core of the gospel. That's the core of our faith. God loved us so much. He loves us deeply. So for 3 years, Christ taught his disciples, mostly by parables. But bit by bit, they experienced his deep and wide love. And these experiences changed their lives, their view of the world, and the way they saw God. But their teacher was now dead. And They felt that their mission was dead too. That's why they were locked in the upper room. They thought it was all over. But Christ shows up the moment of their chaos and fear and says, "Peace be with you." That's all he says. Peace be with you. And then he breathes on them and they receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And this meeting with Christ transfigured their world, transformed their vision, and most importantly, renewed their love for Christ. The risen Christ then comes looking for them and enters into their shame and fear, because that is what they felt. But from him, they glimpse a generosity of spirit, an open hand, inviting him and the disciples back into the love of God. Unfortunately, Thomas wasn't present when Christ first appeared. And when the disciples told him about it, he said, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." So a week goes, and Thomas was with the friends in the upper room. And if you notice, when Christ appears again, the door is still locked. They are still fearful. They are still shocked by what had happened the week before. And he greets them and says, once again, "Peace be with you." And then he invites Thomas to touch his wounds and side. And in amazement, Thomas says, "My Lord and my God." His eyes was open, his heart unlocked, and his vision of Christ was renewed. Like Thomas and the other disciples, we also experience, don't we, moments of doubt and fear. Sometimes our hearts become locked, and fear and doubt can overshadow our lives. It can be the main focus of our attention. The question is, what locked doors prevent you and me moving forward in our relationship with Jesus? What keeps us stuck in the same place, going over and doing the same things over and over again, knowing that they're wrong, but we do them? Just as in the gospel, Christ stands in our midst, is here right now, waiting for us to open our hearts to allow him to enter so he can breathe his peace and life. Therefore, spiritually speaking, we need to take a deep breath and be filled with the presence of the risen Jesus, allowing Christ's breath to provide us with a hope and courage and the strength to unlock our closed hearts, because sometimes we have closed hearts, to open the doors to our resurrection story. The good news is that we can rest knowing that he is always there for us, even when we struggle to understand the things of God, even when we struggle to believe that God really loves us because of the things we do wrong, even when we struggle to understand why our prayers are not answered sometimes. Christ then comes to us, as he did with Thomas, and we can glimpse his peace and deep love. The risen Christ then desires to free us from our closed and locked hearts. He desires to reassure us that his love surpasses our challenges and is greater than our doubts. So our locked hearts, which all of us suffer from, can be opened by allowing Jesus to breathe his peace into our lives. Because he's waiting to talk to you and me and say, "Peace be with you. Be at peace." He's always there. Now, can I do something radical and sing the first verse and chorus of our gradual hymn? You don't have to stand up for it. So let's. What hymn number was it? It was 401. So let's sing the first verse and the in between, the chorus. Okay. All right. Let's now stand and say the creed together. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church.
This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Do please sit for our prayers. God of resurrection, ever renewing, ever reviving, we adore you for your life-giving presence. Son of man, newly risen, sorrow made joy, we adore you for your sacrificial living and dying. Holy Spirit, breathing among us this morn, we adore you for breathing new life into us. Be with us now as we offer our prayers before you. Gracious God, it is our privilege to come together to pray for your world and for your people. So today we come to put our prayers at your disposal. We pray for all who are in the news today, whether willingly or not. Especially we pray for King Charles, the Princess of Wales, and their families as they fight their health battles and media intrusion. We pray for all the people caught up in conflict around the world who find cameras thrust in their faces during times of tragedy. Lord, be present with each one of them today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our church community, our life together in Christ, and our witness to the world. Today we pray particularly for our work with St. Augustine's School, for our Open the Book team, and those who put Fun Day Monday and other activity days together for the children and their families. We lift up the activity morning tomorrow and ask for your special blessing on all who come to it. May they find your face and presence in those they meet here. We pray for Beverly, Michael, and Alfie, and for Stephen this morning as he leads our worship. We pray for our PCC, our church wardens, and all who minister and support our work and worship here. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those we've met or talked to this week who have some important issue to face, thinking particularly of dilemmas or struggles faced by our own family and friends. We pray for those coping with stress at home, in life, or in work, feeling that the world is a dark and dreary place. Pray for those who are not with us today because of illness. And we pray for all those who are waiting, whether for a birth, for a job, for a visit, for a hospital appointment, or maybe a word of forgiveness. We pray for those who are longing for love and friendship and a way out of loneliness. May they find you to lead them to the light. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are not content, who have not yet found their home or their strength within you. And we pray in the silence of our hearts for one or two people we know for whom faith would be both a wonderful gift and a blessing. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Loving Lord, each person we've mentioned in our hearts is known and loved by you more than we could ever imagine. We entrust them to you in confidence and hope, knowing that you will use these prayers for their healing and well-being. For we ask these things in the name of Jesus Christ, who is alive forever with you and the Holy Spirit. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And so we come to the peace. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. So I think we sing our offertory hymn, is it? And St. Francis, my favourite saint, one of his songs, with the words anyway, "Make me a channel of your peace," hymn number 499. Oh, we now sing. We won't be singing "Make Me Channel of Your Peace." We'll be singing "Breathe on Me, Breath of God." I'll blame the sun.
Thank you.
Creator of all, you wash away our sins. You give us new birth by the Spirit and redeem us in the blood of Christ. As we celebrate the resurrection, renew your gift of life within us. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the risen Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Bless you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. From the beginning you created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time you made us in your image, the crown of all creation. You gave us breath and speech, that with angels and archangels, and all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to sing your praise. Wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace a people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread, in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends and, taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. And do this in remembrance of me." On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." By your cross and resurrection,
you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world.
Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice, made once for all upon the cross. We remembering his dying and rising in glory, and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these your gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son, as we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ, and build us into a living temple to your glory. And bring us at last with St. Augustine and all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendour for which you have created us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, and with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty. Songs of everlasting praise.
Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
Rejoicing in the presence of God here among us, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share one bread.
Hallelujah. Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
Thank you. Let us pray. Lord our Father, through our Saviour Jesus Christ, you assured your children of eternal life, and in baptism you have made us one with him. Deliver us from the death of sin, and raise us to new life in your love, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So we say together,
Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace, and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We who live light give life to the world. Keep us far in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Before the blessing, has been a wonderful time I've had with you in worship and fellowship, and I'm looking forward to a cup of coffee. Thank you for the wonderful Rena and her managing me with all the things I forgot to do. Thank you so much. And what wonderful music. And I'm told that the two younger members of the group is off from college for a little holiday. So thank you. What wonderful instruments you have. You know, if you've got some spare time, you could come to Holy Trinity Cookfield. We're looking for music people. Was raised from the dead, strengthening to walk with him in his risen life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Go in his peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Just before our last hymn.
Yes.
Few notices. Sheila, you're probably better on the lectern because you've got a microphone.
Yes, sorry, church warden, you'll get used to that.
Well, first of all, we'd like to say thank you very much for the service today. That was just splendid. Thank you. And made us feel at ease.
Yeah.
And you're able to laugh with us and not mind when we laugh with you. Happens a lot. And we also want to welcome the Reverend David Tickner, who's here today with his wife Janet. And so I hope you'd like to say hello in coffee. And so we welcome you and hope to see you doing services in the near future. Well, not too near, because we've still got there. I just want to draw your attention to Easter activity morning tomorrow. If you've got grandchildren staying or expecting some and you think, what am I going to do with them? Bring them along to Easter activity morning. It's not too late to sign up, but if you could just tell, is it Jenny?
No.
No, good, no. Right answer.
Very
So if you'd just like to tell Jenny, if you would like to do that. On Tuesday the 9th, we've got our beat surgery, so it's when our local police officer comes to, not a surgery, but he comes to chat, be around if there's anything that you want to talk to him about. And prayer spaces on Saturday, 13th of April. Do you want to say something about, I thought you might.
So tonight, it's prayer space, 6 till 7. We're going to be looking at new starts and hope, which I think will really reflect what we've looked at this morning. And then next, on Saturday the 13th, there's this lovely event with some beautiful musicians, Julie and Nigel, coming to play with us. So we're going to have a morning of prayer and worship with these wonderful people. If you want to come to that, do sign up with Karen or I on our sheet. We'd love to have you. I think it'd be a lovely morning. It's just from 9, starting with some actual breakfast and finish by noon. So I think it'd be a lovely event. So do come.
And just one more thing. hit somebody's, well, has been somebody's special birthday last week. Somebody who was 60, Sheila Clark.
Yay!
So.
Our final hymn, whatever it is,
to be God.
To be God.